The Peking Ballet Company is, strangely enough, a good place in which to understand what has happened to China since Mao Zedong's revolution 30 years ago. As China emerges from all the confusions of the last years of Mao Zedong's life, the Peking Ballet Company have gone back to doing something they never thought they'd be allowed to do again, a classical ballet. For the first time in 16 years, they put on Swan Lake.
至于为什么这十几年没什么没演呢？这个天鹅湖其实这个问题确实就像大家都明白，就因为这十年江青，一花独放，不是百花齐放，所以这个外国的经典的好的作品不能在中国和观众前面，我们也是感觉很遗憾，很不愿意的。所以为什么打倒四人帮以后，我们很愿意演出呢？也就是因为这个，因为把他们打倒了，天鹅湖才能可以演出。
感觉就是那种古典芭蕾舞的感觉，这个我们很久没这么跳了，还得把它给找回来，这些都是比较困难的。在跳的时候，因为它这个古典芭蕾要求都是人能够高度的控制自己，所以在肌肉的控制能力方面和体力方面也都是需要有一个锻炼的过程，就是。
嗓子那个地方，当，把那以后这个过来以后，变这个样不记得了，一点也不知道，到这以后该做什么一点也不知道了。完以后突然到这，我想起了，还有一个这个下腰，就是很诱惑他那个感觉，把那个琴音乐一听音乐，想起这个动作知道了，就听到音乐就想起这动作来。 说起这个来啊，一想起来也不太想谈这个问题，因为四人帮给弄的实在是，这是说弄痛苦的回忆吧，把我们弄下边去了，就完全脱离这个芭蕾舞这门事业了。我从小就是12岁就到搞上文艺，可以说是一手党把我培养起来，但是四人帮也不管这些。 把我们培养有一技之长吧，也把我们全弄下去了。有将近有8年的时间吧，让我专门笨重的体力劳动，艰巨的、很艰苦的那干什么呢？他听起来会很可笑，养猪、养马、养兔、养鸡、养鸭，什么都干，掏大粪，这是种大田，这些活，反正繁重劳动，就是根本跟这个行全脱离了。
We didn't perform it for 16 years because within those 16 years, the company was upside down. It was quite chaos. A few of our dancers were handcuffed and sent to prison. The dancers themselves were put against each other. Lots of new contradictions and so on. Oh, we didn't know, it was confusing. And I myself was not allowed. Although I was one of the leaders, I used to be the director of the theater. And I was not allowed to do my work. I was ordered to do menial work and afterwards go to the country to be a farmer.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. The Chinese people are just beginning to sort out in their minds what actually happened to China in the last years of Chairman Mao's life. 1949, Mao Zedong, after years of struggle, led his people to liberation, victory over the Japanese invaders, and the end of the Civil War. He filled the Chinese people with pride and dignity, and with great hope for the future. His people, by and large, have never stopped loving, even worshipping him for it. Mao Zedong was 56 years old at liberation. He said that with liberation, the people had achieved what they knew how to achieve. The fighting was behind them. They would now have to learn about running the country, about economics, and about building socialism. Mao always believed in the power of the arts to educate and change people. He said that art was as strong a weapon as the gun. Artists were all to be cogs in the revolutionary machine, engineers of the human soul.
During the time of Stalin, we were on very good terms. with the Soviet Union. And there was quite a craze of everything Russian. So then our government decided that we should also have ballet. And of course, the Russians are very good at ballet. And we learned in a very short time, because the people were, and the students were very enthusiastic. And after only 4 years, you know, we put on Swan Leap. I'm Chinese. I wasn't born in China. I was born in Trinidad, fourth generation of Chinese. When I was 14 years old, I went to England and lived there for 9 years, studying ballet and modern dancing. And it was only in 1940, when I was 24 years old, I came to China for the first time. There's a very great difference from the old China and the China today. In the old China, the people were starving. They would sell their children, no way to feed them.
我是怎么参加这个学习这个芭蕾舞的呢？我自己也不知道，其实一开始小时候很天真，我小时候读书读得不太好，父亲呢怕我考不上中学，父亲怕我考不上中学呢，就从报纸上就看到这个舞蹈学校招生的这个消息。 然后呢，他就让我去考。其实，在这之前，我并不知道什么叫芭蕾舞。因为我们在小时候，如果考不上中学，在家里闲的感觉时间很不光彩的事情。所以，父亲呢，怕我考不上，想让我上这儿试试，上舞蹈学校试试。
我刚才说的意思就是说，中国知识界比较多一些，看的这个对天赋比较感兴趣，工人农民还不是非常了解的。但一般在城市里边呢。 工人比农民还是多一些，所以我们下去深入生活，有时候到，农村呐、啊、什么的，他们看也挺愿意看，像条四小天鹅，哎，挺好的，挺可爱，挺美丽的，蹦的都挺齐的，他们说。<笑>但是呢，真正让他了解，他就不太清楚了，不太明白了。反正看了以后觉得挺美的，也挺可爱的，小小鹅啊，什么大鹅什么的。
白天鹅，他都觉得挺好的，但是具体的情况呢，他这个对这个作品的那个时代的什么这个意义都是不太了解。因为我父亲从来没看过芭蕾舞，第一次，他也不知道芭蕾舞到底什么样。他看了，看完以后呢，我想他一定会很高兴，但没想到我回家的时候呢，他不是很高兴。<笑>他说：“你在台上为什么好像连裤子也不穿呢？对吧？” 那女同志好像上身也不穿，她觉得很不习惯，很不习惯，把头发又那么长，所以她觉得很不行。我也感觉很，我也感觉好像很难跟她来介绍，但是我还是把外国的一些这个习惯啊或者什么跟她做了一些介绍。 因为他毕竟没有接触过，把外国的一些风俗习惯跟他做了介绍，他后来还是表示理解。但是在这之前呢，他是属于不理解，而且是属于有点责怪我的意思吧。但是后来跟他讲了以后，他还是理解。
请一。一 plié， 一直的弯，直的不动。大一 plié 往后，画到旁边，再到前边是五位。同时 plié 一，不要撅屁股。大是五位，然后再 plié， 注意重心。这样是松的，脑子都在这个位置上。一二三四，同时半脚尖，同时劈叶，动力腿从这儿不动，半脚尖，然后往回走，二三四，把腮同时一块儿动力腿，半脚尖，来吧，站好。
我得按照主席的这个文艺方向、文艺路线去走。我们从舞蹈学校毕业的时候，就说了要培养有。社会主义文化的，对，有一定的专业技能的这样的一个文艺工作者，我们的学校毕业证书上就培养人才就是这样的，所以我们作为一个演员来说，要为社会主义这个无产阶级政治服务，要为这个工农兵服务，这是我们的文艺方针，所以作为一个文艺工作者来说，也应该是遵循这条道路的。
The early 60s were the lowest point of Mao Zedong's life. He'd fallen out with the Russians, and the economy was failing. People were starving again. By the time he was 70, Mao had been eased upstairs to write his thoughts and his poems, to brood over the failings of his party, and over how difficult it was to change people.Despite years of revolution, he saw everywhere what he called the four O's, old ideology, old culture, old customs, old ideas. He saw his revolution degenerating, going soft, going, as he saw it, the same way as Russia's revolution.
大一。
put his wife Jiang Qing in charge of the revolution in the arts. The Peking Ballet Company became a model company for the rest of China.
In 1964, we performed the Red Detachment of Women, the new ballet, and put on a special performance for our leader, Chairman Mao Zedong. We were very excited, and you can imagine how everybody felt, very happy. And after our performance, he came onto the stage and shook hands with all of us and shouted, of course, long live Chairman Mao. Jiang Qing, who was the wife of Chairman Mao, she already controlled our company. She always said in the dance, we have to be rebellious. That is why the ballet dancing became lots of fists and open hands like that. You had to have it very open and very straight or a fist. She wouldn't allow it. You have to be rebellious. She said, you can't be rebellious in a graceful way.
所以他这一改呢就成了他的了，就是，所以捞现成果子来，成了他，这不很明显的，我们那当时也不明白是他是什么样，就他说什么我们听什么，他说什么我们听什么，就这样。
Well, of course, one could not disagree with her. I'll tell you this, that you know, China has a 2,000 years of feudalist history. So that is why I can say we are so obedient. She made a public speech saying that since liberation of China from 1949, even up to that time in 1966,For these 17 years, there was not a red line. There was a black line in the arts. And she said, the black line is not only long, it's also very thick. And in this way, the Ministry of Culture, all the ministers were hit down. All of them. Not one got away.
In 1966, at the age of 73, Mao Zedong, supported closely by his wife Jiang Qing, launched the Cultural Revolution. It was his final attempt to root out all those officials lacking in revolutionary zeal. They were called revisionists. It was also his last chance to regain power.And push China further down the road to true socialism. For the youth and the masses, Mao was now close to being a god. We will smash the old world to 1,000 pieces, they said, and create a new world.
You tell me.一开始文化大革命当中，我自己觉得一开始啊，还是属于比较正常的情况下。这个一开始呢，我们对我们的领导有些意见，有些意见我们就贴了一些大字报。这个贴了一些大字报的时候呢，领导就不高兴呢，他们就开始记你， 比如说我写的打字报写在那，他就写，把它抄下来，以后要跟我们算账。完了这个时候呢，六月一号那大字报出来了以后呢，等于中央支持群众给领导贴大字报，贴大字报以后呢，我们就感觉有了人支持，有上头支持，中央支持。这个时候我们就是连夜写了很多大字报，就是那天晚上基本上就没有睡觉，在这个教室，在那个教室，还有就那边那个
走廊，
全部都是大字报，这个地方全挂上绳子，就挂上绳子，一张一张大字报，大字报从很高就拖到地方。这个时候他们就感到群众的这个力量非常大，他们有点紧张，他们一些
就等于运动基本上全都起来了，
起来了，而且这个是没有人来鼓动的，
哎，是起来了以后呢，而且中央呢也出了文件了，
而且当时的目的就是为了改变一些不合理的、不正常的一些可以说官僚主义吧，就领导提了一些意见，没有什么不要他们什么批改他们领导，不是属于这样。是属于很正常的一些意见，但是他们紧张。
Well, of course, when the Cultural Revolution started in 1966, really it was quite a shock to me personally, because I didn't know as many people, even party members, didn't know what was happening above. I mean, among the higher leaders, we didn't understand, we didn't know, so it was quite a shock, and. We did not know what was happening. And then in our company, there was the Red Guard movement. And we had lots of fractions. And everyone trying to be a revolutionary.
就那个思想啊，都是按照中央的那个东西走的。但是后来慢慢的运动。逐渐被西方利用，走上了邪，还带着一种正确的思想，要革命，就是中国应该要往前发展的那样一种正确的思想。是从这方面，大家伙儿积极地按照中央的这个行动号召来办事情，所以基本上还是比较有条理的，该出大字报啊，或者是该质问一些个人呐、啊，或者有些问题啊，应该要讲清楚的，还是按照这个。后来因为一出现了工作队以后，把这些东西全部先压下去，然后再反过来，
那是长
这事情，
那就复杂
了。
挡不挡那个帘幕？肯定还是。啊，就是这个柱子后头那个杆儿。帘幕。啊，帘幕你放。
帘幕你放下来，放下来，看咱这挡着不挡着。
In 1966, the news came that the leaders of the Peking City, they were.Traitors and so on. Well, it became quite a shock for us. And then there was the directives of the Cultural Revolution that within the party there's a capitalist line. And we have to hit down the capitalist line. This is a question for the whole country.If China would follow the socialist line, the socialist road, or they go the capitalist road, there's a big struggle. And everybody has to take part in this. So at the very beginning, in our company, the party leaders in the company, they were immediately isolated.To be inspected.
对，是什么？但是一开始就是三民三高，明白吗？三民三高就是黑尖子，文艺黑线的黑尖子，其实现在都已经都明白了，都没什么。名演员，就因为这个原因，高个占了。就算是哪个团里都得揪出点东西来，
就我就算我们团里的我救出来了，他们那些比较其他的演员呢，像那个什么张昭他们，就算横扫一切牛鬼蛇神，也稍微贴点大字报，我就说把他揪出来了，跟他们那个左字派一块儿。这你怎么谈的？你看看，就是运动的冲击，刚开始说，算你说三明三高往里面揪出来这样。
In October, then Chen Qing asked, well, why up to now you haven't touched Thailand? Well, only this word alone. Then the people, you know, there are different factions. Then they immediately isolated me, gave me orders. First, that I was isolated, I mean,I was shut up and I couldn't leave my room at the beginning. And after that, and they would come and interrogate me to find out about my history. They said you must be suspicious of everybody. The idea is this, that you have to expose anything that is against Chairman Mao's thoughts. You have to expose them.Ask you a question. Is that right or not? You said yes or no? That's right. You just have to listen to orders, because the power is in the hand of the masses. That's what he's saying. That's what he's saying. The power is in the hand of the masses.
你们能不能听音乐呀？不要拖，音乐快的话你们就要跟音乐，音乐慢的话你们也要跟音乐。
我记得就是在礼堂，就在四楼礼堂，就是你忘了吗？肖慎、刘敬堂他们所有人全都去了，其中有一张大字报，就是说当时直问党委，是不是就是肖慎是不是走资派？刘敬堂说：“我保留自己的意见。”到现在我认为他是同志，你记得吗？那次整个就全乱了，结果大家伙就说不对，他就是走资派，所以就矛头基本上都冲他去了，就是我们的第一把手。所以那个时候呢，就是给刘敬堂记着，他说他不是他自己不是走资派，而肖慎呢，他认为也不是走资派，他认为还是同志，所以从那以后就整个全团就全乱了，属于这样。
We were told that we must, that they will send us to the country, and we must be there, prepared to be there for a long time. So we were, after putting our baggage, you know, onto our backs, and then we got onto trucks, and so that they took us to the countryside to work in the fields. Put our packs on our backs and go ahead. I mean, there's no choice. Really, you have no choice. You just had to listen. We had to listen. I mean, what they want you to do, you just had to do. Otherwise, you'll get beaten. Really, you'll get beaten. I saw somebody I knew. He was a very famous Chinese actor. I know him well. Many times when we used to go abroad to perform, I used to take the dancers with me, and he would take the Chinese opera people. And there he was moving bricks. He was doing building. So I nodded to him, and he looked to see if anybody was looking. And then he just, like that to me. So I knew that, he wasn't having a good time. Yes.
在该校的生活就没法说，反正是没有人身的自由，假期不给假期，看电影也不给看电影。这个每天早上起来很早起来去那个到那个外边去施粪，那不是农村吗？完了施粪完了以后回来呢，再给大家烧水，烧完水以后自己才洗脸呢，刷牙什么的，完了以后才给大家去打饭，把饭打回来放到那个桌子上，这个时候呢才跟一块吃。反正我们在那个地方劳动吧，反正是属于那种监督劳动，就每天吧，大家都是，就是有人看着你。劳动不是那种好像我们就劳动，很成为一种愉快的那样，不是这样的。你干什么活都是别人看着你的，你干不好当场就批判你。反正最明显的例子是什么呢？就把那时候我们在果园劳动，劳动的时候呢，就这个。不让你这个故意的弄一块地方吧，很硬。那时候冬天挖树坑，你知道吗？弄苹果把那个树坑挖了，还故意把那块地给你弄得很硬的，让你去挖。当时把手脚什么都弄破了，鞋也弄破了。你挖到一定时间你挖不出来，马上大伙儿都过来过来，就站在那儿就批判你，为什么这个时间你不把它挖出来？别人都挖完了，你为什么不挖？实际上他们是故意的，就是把这一块地吧特别特别给你冻得特别厉害，他要你挖，要规定时间你挖，挖不出来就当场就批判你，就这么来罚你吧。所以我当时也不知道这个情况，这时间卖力挖挖挖还是没挖到时间，没挖出来，就这么来罚你，动不动就你要高兴了吧，你就忘，就怎么忘，不服罪了，不认罪了，你要那你就是好像感觉挺难受的时候，又觉得你怎么你给你这么好的时间老好好改造自己，你还不好好改造，你怎么又不服罪了？高兴的时候你又得意忘形了，反正就是哭不得笑不得，总之吧，反正是不让你过平平安安的过日子那样，反正每天早上就是这样。所以当时我们最感到精神上的压力特别大，特别害怕，不知道什么时候就来批判你，不知道什么时候就来，就是把你提了出来，就当众啊，就给你弄得下不来台。当然不是，也说不上下不来台，就是说，就批判你吧，也不知道什么时候，所以一天到晚提心吊胆的在那生活。有时候睡觉做的梦，突然之间觉得好像就叫醒了，我就发现我自己好几次这样，睡觉突然就叫醒了，别人又怎么回事？完了还第二天还批判你， 怎么睡觉你还不认罪，睡觉你还想这些事儿，就是总而言之这些事情嘛，从精神上折磨你，使得你就是老也抬不起头来，就是你就要好好干吧，就是那样的，干最脏最累的活，弄粪的大粪车的，跟他到城里来挑粪的什么的。所以当时我这个体型不像现在这样这么瘦，当时胖得不得了，弄了两块这块肌肉都这么高了，因为挑水这地方必须要用这个肩膀那个肌肉弄，所以像一弄那么高。所以回来以后我恢复开始练业务的时候，这块肌肉下不去，你知道吗？芭蕾舞的演员的体型要是很那长瘦长的，那个时候我的两块肌肉就起来了。所以现在我这还是留的痕迹呢，所以现在感觉到就是说那个时候最痛苦就是精神上的最大的折磨，对我们压制我。
In my opinion, and I think that it's the opinion of many people, was that the Gang of Four isolated him. He couldn't know what was happening outside. And I know that some people who wanted to write a letter to him, he wouldn't get the letters. And I have heard of some incidents when some person tried ways to let him to send a note to him, but as far as we knew that they were isolating him, not letting him hear the voice of the people.
Mao Zedong died in September 1976. 3 weeks later, his wife Jiang Qing and her three closest colleagues, now known as the Gang of Four, were arrested.
后呢，我才是真正的从政治上到艺术上，我才让我真正跳起来了。舞台上才让我能要跳天鹅湖，红色将军也让我跳了，其他节目也让我跳了。政治上我就翻过来，把我打成反革命，我也就翻过来，没有，根本不是这么。我从小红领巾长大的时候，反革命我反谁呀？
这个斗争会呢，我们舞剧团还是开过一些呢，但是如果讲的确切的话，是分两个阶段。第一个阶段呢，就是说文化大革命刚开始的时候，对一些我们的当权派就是原剧团的领导，对他们呢，因为他们过去在文化大革命之前呢执行了一些错误的东西，我们当时参加他们斗争会是真心的想帮助他们，想批判他们，就说他们那种是错的，是修正主义，所以我们大家情绪很高，大家也真的参加进去，可能有些幼稚的东西，但是主要的出发点呢，是为了避免出现修正主义，怕走苏联这条路。
经过反正很艰苦的一段时间吧，确实躺在床上疼啊，抬不起来，脚趾头也疼了，腿也疼，下不了床，走不了道，但是第二天起来还咬着牙还练习，就这样一段时间恢复过来了。 再加上我年龄也比较大，也不像当年十八岁的那时候，现在将近四十岁了，月年底就四十岁了，所以我的体力增加来说，确实经过一番很艰苦的这样一个锻炼过程，才适应了这样舞台的这样一个生，这个舞台这个环境，这样一个舞台的生活。
可以哈，他今天还凑合，还凑合。这个就有一个这个白带儿呢，露在外头，这白带儿。
我没关系，白带儿没问题。
这就这样的吧，好不好？
还可以，真是。
先试试，
行吗？
行。可以，完了我明天这样就弄一个那个然后这个在外面。
我感觉这个地方没人，地方太肥了。
今天晚上开演时间是7:15。今天晚上开演时间是7:15。现在的时间是6:50。现在的时间是6:50。离开演时间还有25分钟。离开演时间还有25分钟。
本来外边发展的很快，我们呢又不让看，又不让听，所以我们落后了很多很多，差距越来越大。所以现在反正是要尽快赶上那个时机。
Thank you.